students, today we are going to learn the types of forest. What we learned in the previous class? Yes, we learned about forest and wildlife. We learned about forest and wildlife. We know that from our surroundings forest is present. So in then what we learned? We learned about the different sources present our nature that are called natural resources. What are natural resources? Air, water, then sunlight, soil, minerals, forest, etc. are called natural resources. Okay, then what we learned? The types of natural resources we learned. What are the different types? What are the two types of natural resources? Yes, exhaustible natural resources and inexhaustible natural resource. Exhaustible natural resource and inexhaustible natural resource. Okay, all of you understand? Yes, what are exhaustible natural resources? Yes, the exhaustible natural resources means that if we overuse the natural resources, it is what happened to that? Yes, it is extinct from our earth. Its quantity is reduced, or its the quantity of the exhaustible natural resources are reduced or limited in quantity. So such a type of natural resources are called exhaustible natural resources. Okay, next example for exhaustible natural resources, we can say that natural gases, petroleum, minerals, coals, etc. are example for exhaustible natural resources. Then inexhaustible natural resources are that resources are abundant in our earth. Then it does not reduce by the use, overuse, and also it is plenty of inexhaustible natural resources are present in our earth. For example, air, water, sunlight, then soil, etc. are example for inexhaustible natural resources. Okay, next what we learn? Yes, we learn about how we can conserve our resources. How we can conserve our resources? Conservation of resources. What do you mean by conservation of resources? We can conserve our exhaustible resources. We should save our exhaustible resources, because it is limited in quantity. If we overuse it, it become reduced, it become extinct from our earth. So we will face a very issue faced by the disappearing of exhaustible resources from the earth. Okay, next step. What do you mean by extinction? We know that some resources are extincted from our earth. What do you mean by extinction? Extinction means the disappearing of animals from the earth. Extinction means the disappearing of animals from the earth. Disappearing of animals from the earth is called extinction. The disappearing of animals from the earth is called extinction. How extinction takes place? The extinction takes place due to hunting. Hunting of animals. We know that tigers are extincted from our earth due to man's hunting towards the tigers. So our government will start some programs for conserve some extincted animals, for saving some extincted animals. So for example, to conserve the tigers, tigers are in the category of an extincted species. So for conserving the tigers, our government produced some programs, that is save the tiger. Then what we learn? Yes, we learn about forest and its importance. Forest and its importance. devotees. We know that what we pay forest, what we can understand from the word forest. We know that we can see the forest around us. We forest around us because we live in a forest area. We live in a forest area. So forest means a large area of land which is fully covered with the naturally growing plants and trees. Naturally growing plants and trees. That means a forest. What do you mean by forest? A forest means a large area of land. A large area of land is fully covered with the naturally growing plants and trees. Naturally growing plants and trees are called a forest. So what is the importance of forest? So forest is very helpful for the human beings because it will help to reduce the soil erosion. It will help to reduce the soil erosion and also for soil erosion, floods, and also it will give a shelter to a large variety of plants and animals. We know that the wild animals are living better in forest. So the forest should give a very large shelter for a large variety of animals and plants. And also the forest give us timber, then what? Firewood, rubber, gums, resins, then fruits, medicinal herbs, etc. We get from where? Forest. We get from forest. So from this we can understand forest is a part of our life. Forest is a part of our life. It is very helpful for the survival, for maintaining the survival of human beings. So we should conserve the forest. We should conserve the forest and the species present in the forest. The plant species and also the animal species. Okay. Next we learn about, we know that some people were living in forest, some tribal communities are living in forest. Then they get all the things, their shelter, food, etc. get from their forest itself. So they considered us forest is their society. Okay. Next, when we learn, today we are going to learn about the types of forest. We know that different types of forest are present in our country, in our world. So first one is evergreen forest or tropical rainforest. Evergreen forest or tropical rainforest. Evergreen forest means that throughout the year the green color of the forest remains throughout the year because the leaves of the trees and plants do not shed their leaves at the same time. Okay. Next, the tropical rainforest means we know that lots of plants and trees are present in a forest. That area get more rain. So evergreen forest gets rain, plenty of rain. Then evergreen forests are found in the Western Ghats and in the Andaman and Nicobar and Island and in the Northeastern states such as Assam, Arunachal Pradesh and Meghalaya. Next, in evergreen forests, some evergreen trees we can see in evergreen forests. The trees are mahogany, ebony and rosewoods are the example from some evergreen trees present in evergreen forest. Okay. Next we learn about deciduous forest. Next, first forest is what? Evergreen forest. Evergreen forest or tropical rainforest or tropical. Evergreen forest or tropical rainforest. This we know that throughout the year the green color of the forest remains throughout the year. the trees and all the trees and plants in the evergreen forest does not shed their leaves at the same time. Then we can see the evergreen forest in the Western Ghats, in the Western slope of the Western Ghats and in Andaman and Nicobar Island, and also in the northeastern states such as Assam, Arunachal Pradesh and Meghalaya. Then some evergreen trees, example for some evergreen trees are mahogany, ebony and rosewood. Next type of forest is deciduous forest. Deciduous forest
means all monsoon forest. These forests, the deciduous forest or monsoon forest, another name for deciduous forest is monsoon forest. These monsoon forests or deciduous forests we can see in the foothills of the Himalayas. We can see the deciduous forest or monsoon forest in the foothills of Himalayas. Then the leaves of the trees are shed every year during the dry season, during the summer season. So in deciduous forest or the monsoon forest, the trees shed their leaves during dry season. And then the trees that grow in deciduous forest are sal, sandalwood, then mahua and teak. Which are the trees that grow in deciduous forest? Sal, then sandalwood, mahua and what? Teak. These are the trees which grow in where? In which forest? Deciduous forest or monsoon forest? Deciduous forest or monsoon forest. Sal, sandalwood, mahua and teak are the trees which grow in deciduous forest. Then such forest, the deciduous forest or monsoon forest we can see in our country, in the states Madhya Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Kerala and Karnataka. Where we can see the deciduous forest or monsoon forest in our country? In the states Madhya Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Kerala and Kerala. These are the states which the deciduous forest present. Okay. Next we learn about thorny and scrub forest. Thorny and scrub forest. As the name, if the name gets for the forest, thorny and scrub forest means the thorny and bush plants are present in the forest. So the name gets thorny and scrub. In this forest, lots of thorny and scrub plants are present. So the forest is named as thorny and scrub forest. Then in this forest, many varieties of shrubs are present. These are found in Rajasthan and the dry areas of Punjab, Haryana, Madhya Pradesh and Maharashtra. The thorny and scrub forest can be found where? Rajasthan, then Punjab, Haryana, Madhya Pradesh and Maharashtra. Then thorny plants are able to survive in dry areas because they need less water. The thorny plants, thorns, the plants which contain thorns, so they are called thorny plants. So these plants does not need more water for growing. It need only less water. So these thorny plants are grown in the areas, dry areas, because it needs less water content, for their growth. Then in thorn forest we can see some trees in the thorn forest. The trees for thorn forest are thicker and
bubble, bubble, kicker and bubble are the trees which are present in the thorny forest. The trees which are present in the thorny forest. The thorny plants need only less water for their growth. So these are found in dry areas. Then in Rajasthan, Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Punjab and Haryana. Examples for thorny trees are kikar and bubble. Next forest, mountain forest or coniferous forest. Mountain forest or coniferous forest. Fourth one, mountain forest. Mountain forest or coniferous forest. Mountain forest or coniferous forest. The mountain forest or the coniferous forest are found in the Himalayan region. Mountains we can see in the Himalaya. So these mountain forests or coniferous forests are found in the Himalayan region. And also we can see the mountain forest or the coniferous forest in the parts of Nilgiris in Kerala and Tamil Nadu. Nilgiris in Kerala and Tamil Nadu. We can see the mountain forest or coniferous forest in the Himalayan region, and also we can see the mountain forest in the part of Nilgiris of Kerala and Tamil Nadu. Next, these forests are fully covered with a cone-shaped trees that are tall and have a thick bark. So the name get for coniferous forest, the mountain forest get the name coniferous forest name, because this forest, most of this forest contains a cone shaped trees. Contains a forest are covered with a cone shaped trees that are tall and they have a thick bark. Then their leaves are narrow and pointed. That means pointed means needle shaped leaves have the coniferous trees or cone shaped trees. Okay, then example for the trees are spruce, deodar, fir and pine. Okay, the deciduous. Here we can see the trees in our textbook, trees in an evergreen forest. So we can see the color of the forest is green color. Then this is a trees in an evergreen forest. We can see mahogany, ebony and rosewood. This is the deciduous forest. Deciduous forest means sal, sandalwood, mahua, teak, etc. are present. Then in kikar trees in the thorn forest. Kikar trees means in thorn forest means it contains so many thorns. Here we can see the mountain forest or the coniferous forest. So mountain forest or coniferous forest is present on the Himalayan region and also in the part of Nilgiris in Tamil Nadu and Kerala. And in mountain forest or coniferous forest is fully covered with the cone shaped trees which are tall. We can see the trees which are cone shaped trees. We can see that. Then here we can see the cone shaped trees which are tall and have a thick bark, and the leaves of these trees are narrow and pointed, or means needle shaped leaves is present for the coniferous trees. Coniferous trees. Example for coniferous forest or mountain forest. The trees present in the coniferous forest or mountain forest are spruce, then deodar, fir and pine are the exact trees present in the coniferous forest. Next forest name is marshy and tidal forest. Marshy and tidal forest. Fifth one, marshy and tidal, forest, marshy and tidal forest. Marshy and tidal forests are found in the deltas of the major rivers such as Ganga, Mahanadi and Godavari. The marshy means, we know that marshy means clay. Most of the clay is present in these land areas. So marshy and tidal forest is present on the deltas of the major rivers such as Ganga, Mahanadi and Godavari. Ganga, Mahanadi and Godavari. The marshy and tidal forest we can see on the deltas of the rivers such as the Ganga, Mahanadi and Godavari. Then these are also known as mangrove forests. The marshy and tidal forests are also known as mangrove forests. Mangrove forest. The marshy and tidal forest. We can see the marshy and tidal forest on the deltas of the rivers such as Ganga, Mahanadi and Godavari. These are also known as mangrove forests. After the mangrove trees that grows in the in these forests. Why we can say that the marshy and tidal forest is also known as mangrove forest? Because the mangrove trees are grown in these areas. Mangrove trees are grown in these areas. Okay, so we can say that these forests is also called a mangrove forest. Okay, then another factor about the mangrove forest is means the mangrove trees are grown in saline water. The mangrove trees are grown in which water? Saline water means salty water. Okay, they have stilt roots that hang above the mud and water to absorb air. These mangrove trees are grown in which water? Saline water, and their roots are stilt roots that hang above the mud and water to absorb air. Once again, about mangrove forest. Mangrove forests are grown in saline water. Its roots are stilt roots which hang on the mud and water for absorbing the air for their growth. Then the Sundarban forest in Ganga Brahmaputra Delta have been named after the mangrove trees that grow there. The Sundarban forest in Ganga Brahmaputra is also contains the mangrove trees. Once again, about marshy and tidal forest. The marshy and tidal forests are also known as mangrove forests. These forests we can see on the deltas of the rivers such as Ganga, Mahanadi and Godavari. Then these marshy and tidal forest is also known as mangrove forest because the mangrove trees are grown in these areas. The peculiarities or the properties of the mangrove trees are, the mangrove trees are only grown in saline water. It is grown in which water? Saline water. And these roots are still root, so it hang on the water and the mud for absorb air. Inside the mud, it does not get proper air for their growth, so it hang on the mud and water. So it has stilt roots, so it hang on the mud and water for absorbing what? For absorbing air. So, and also in the Sundarban forest, we can see the mangrove trees. In that forest also contain the mangrove. mangrove trees, the forest, that forest also in the deltas of the river Ganga and Brahmaputra. All of you understand about the different four types of forest in our earth. What is the first name of the first forest? First forest is the evergreen forest or tropical rainforest. Second name of the forest is deciduous forest. Then third one, thorny and scrub forest, mountain forest or coniferous forest. Then marshy and tidal. Last one, marshy and tidal forest. Next we move on to the next topic, that is conservation of forest. First important thing is that if the value of a forest contains valuable resources, so we should conserve our resources because it is needed for our future life. So we know that the depletion of forest lead to a great loss to mankind. Means depletion of forest means the destroying of forest is very not a good thing for the human being. Here we can say that the humans have been cutting trees and for what purpose the human beings cutting trees from the forest? For making houses, then for making houses for timbers, for firewood, etc. Like that. Due to this the forest become destroyed. So, and also the human beings destroy or cutting down the trees from the forest for claiming the land, forest land, for their agricultural purpose. Okay. So the large scale cutting of trees has led to the destruction of forests, large number of forests. So from this destruction of forests due to cutting of trees is known as deforestation. Okay, what do we mean by deforestation? All human beings should conserve our forest because it is related to all the mankind. And also some people in our earth cutting a large number of trees from the forest for different purposes, like for making houses, and also they claim for the land forest for their agriculture. So due to this, the cutting of for trees that goes to the destruction of forest, that is known as deforestation. So to conserve our forest we have to stop cutting trees. We should take care for our forest. Okay, so we have to stop cutting trees. So we should be careful about planting trees for making forest. That is called reforestation. New trees must be grown on the deforest lands to reclaim the forest. This is called reforestation. Deforestation and reforestation. Deforestation and reforestation means new plants can be new trees or plants that is grown from the land or land of destruction of forest. So that is called reforestation. If first of all the human beings, the destruction of forest is done due to cutting of trees, that means the deforestation. For overcoming the deforestation, we should do the reforestation. Means for we should recreate our forest again. We should recreate our forest again. How we can recreate our forest? We should plant trees, new plants and trees in the destructed forest. Okay. Next, and also we should, the people should be aware of the harms of destroying forest. If we destroying our forest, it will leads to soil erosion, flood, then what we should like process in our earth. So we should aware of the harms of destroying, harmful effects of destroying forest, and we should encourage for conserving our forest. So every year in the month, in the beginning of monsoon, to spread awareness about the conservation of forest, the human beings or the people conduct Vana Mahotsav celebrated in every year during the monsoon season, for giving the awareness about the conservation of forest. Okay, then during this festival, during the festival of Vana Mahotsav, they planted so many trees during this festival, during the festival Vana Mahotsav. Okay, then next we learn about conservation of wildlife. Next, conservation of wildlife. First we learn about conservation of forest. How we can conserve forest? We should avoid the deforestation. We should encourage the reforestation. Encourage reforestation, avoid deforestation. Next we learn about conservation of wildlife. How we can conserve our wildlife? Conservation. Of wildlife. We know that in our Indian forests and also all over the world, we know that inside the forest lots of animals are present. Inside the forest lots of animals are lived in the forest. So some people hunted the wild animals. So that animals throughout the hunting process, that animals get extincted from the for example, the Indian cheetah and Indian aurochs etc. are extincted from our country. Okay, then even today many animals being killed for their wild purposes. Some people kill the wild animals for their skin, then for their fleeces or fur, or for their teeth etc. like that, for their body parts. So that because if we sell the body parts of some wild animals into the market, we get more earnings. We get more earnings of money. So in order to avoid these activities of human beings, we should save the wild animals from the extinction. So the government has created many wildlife sanctuaries and the national parks. Wildlife sanctuaries and wildlife sanctuaries and wildlife sanctuaries and national parks. Wildlife sanctuaries and national parks can be created by the our government for conserving the extinct animals from the earth. Okay, some in your textbook in our country right now there are 543 wildlife sanctuaries and 104 national parks are present in India. 543 wildlife sanctuaries. 543 wildlife sanctuaries and 104 national parks are present in India. 104 national parks are present in India right now. Right now, the wildlife sanctuaries, 543 wildlife sanctuaries are and 104 national parks are present in our country. Okay, in your textbook, some name of some our wildlife sanctuaries, national parks are given. First one, Keoladio National Park in Bharatpur. First, Keoladio National Park in Bharatpur, that is in Rajasthan. In this park, famous for migratory birds that come here from Afghanistan, China and Siberia in winters. This park is famous for, why this first park is famous? Because this park is situated in which state? Rajasthan, Bharatpur in Rajasthan. Rajasthan is famous for migratory birds that Bharatpur. So Rajasthan is famous for migratory birds that come from Afghanistan, China and Siberia in winters. So this park is very famous. Next park, national park is Jim Corbett National Park in Uttarakhand. Jim Corbett National Park in Uttarakhand, which is the oldest national park in India, and it is famous for having the highest number of tigers in India. The Jim Corbett National Park in Uttarakhand, here we can see the tigers. Next park is Sundarban National Park. It is situated in West Bengal. It is famous for Royal Bengal Tiger and the mangrove trees. The Sundarban National Park, we can see the Royal Bengal Tigers and mangrove trees we can see. So it is situated in which state? Yes, West Bengal. Next, Kasaranga National Park. Kasaranga National Park we can see in Assam. It is famous for one horned rhinoceros. So these animals are extinct species from our earth. So we should conserve. Our government should conserve these animals in these national park. Next, Bandipur National Park in Karnataka, famous for its tigers, leopards and spotted deer. The Bandipur National Park in Karnataka, famous for tigers, leopards and spotted deers. Next, Gir National Park in Gujarat, it is famous for Asiatic lion. All of you listen. First, Keoladio National Park in Bharatpur. Jim Corbett National Park. Next is Sundarban National Park. Sundarban National Park in West Bengal. रॉयल बंगाल टाइगर्स इज नेम रॉयल बंगाल टाइगर्स मींस कासिरंगा कासिरंगा नेशनल पार्क इज सिचुएटेड वेयर आसाम कासिरंगा नेशनल पार्क नेक्स्ट बंदीपुर नेशनल पार्क कर्नाटक गिर नेशनल पार्क गुजरात ओके आवर लेसन इज ओवर सो नेक्स्ट वी मूव ऑन टू आवर एक्सरसाइज पोर्शन ऑल ऑफ यू लिसन चूज द करेक्ट आंसर द अदर नेम गिवन टू डेसिडस फॉरेस्ट इज विच इज द अदर नेम गिवन टू मनसून फॉरेस्ट डेसिडस फॉरेस्ट और मनसून फॉरेस्ट द माउंटेन फॉरेस्ट आर ऑल्सो नोन एज माउंटेन फॉरेस्ट आर ऑल्सो नोन एज व्हाट कॉनिफरस फॉरेस्ट What kind of forests are found in Andaman and Nicobar Islands? Andaman and evergreen forest. Which of these we do not get from trees? Plastics. Which of these trees will be found in the evergreen forest? Mahogany. Which of these is an exhaustible natural resources? Coal. Next, fill up the ash we get from trees is used to build houses. What timber? Dash forests require a warm place with plenty of rainfall. Evergreen. Places with a sandy soil and a little rainfall will have a dash forest. In which forest gets in which forest but Thorny forest. Dash led the Chipko movement. Sundarlal Bahuguna led the Chipko movement because the Chipko movements means the people in these movements the people hug their tree or hug the trees because to save the trees from cutting down. Next, the Dash National Park in Gujarat is the only place where Asiatic lions are found. Gir National Park. Dash National Park in Gujarat is the only place where Asiatic lion are found. Gir National Park. Answer the following. What is the unique feature of coniferous forest? This is a unique feature of coniferous forest means we have already studied the coniferous forest full of coniferous forest is covered with the cone shaped trees which is tall and with a thick bark. Briefly discuss the Chipko movement. The Chipko movements the Sundarlal Bahuguna led the Chipko movement and the people of what the villages used to hug the trees in order to save the trees from cutting down. What steps have the government taken to protect wildlife? The government created wildlife sanctuaries and a national park to protect wildlife. Next, what are soft and hardwood used for? We know that the soft wood is used for manufacturing doors, windows, etc. The hardwoods are used for making musical instruments, then flooring, then etc. Next, what are the advantages of having wildlife sanctuaries and wildlife parks? For to conserve our forest and also to save the extinct animals from the earth. So our lesson is over. All of you read your lesson. Then write your notes in your social studies notebook. After writing, take a photo and send it to me. Okay, thank you.